Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video I'll show you what are the best modes that you can use with the Dwarf II Smart Telescope to capture a solar eclipse. Also I'll talk about the best settings that you can use to capture the eclipse with the Dwarf II Telescope. We have a few options that we can consider, like 4K video mode, time-lapse mode, bus mode and astro mode. These are the four choices that Dwarf II makes available for us. Now let's talk about the first two, 4K video mode and second, the time-lapse mode. Between the 4K video mode and the time-lapse mode, I'll just go and select the time-lapse mode because it will not occupy so much space and it will be about the same quality as the 4K video mode. Dwarf Lab improved the bus mode. So we have an improved bus mode that has also an interval option. It will allow us to use the bus mode like the time-lapse mode. However, using the bus mode we'll get better images, will not be so compressed, that means better quality, and we'll also have access to all the images. So let's say if something happens, an error, or the Dwarf II will shut down and will not save the time-lapse video or the 4K video, so the first two options that were on my list in the past, you might lose the data. However, with the bus mode, Dwarf II, if already saved the images on the SD card, you'll have the data safe. 4K video mode and time-lapse mode, I'm not considering them anymore for the solar eclipse in 2024 with the Dwarf II. The mode that I do recommend to use now is one, the bus mode. This would be the most easy mode to use and it will give you good quality. And second, it will be the astro mode. I'll say this is an advanced option to use because you'll have to make also some post-processing after later on. And I will make a tutorial how to do this by using the astro mode. However, the astro mode will give you the best quality possible. We have also another inconvenience now. To change the manual settings in astro mode, you need to stop the plan, change the settings and restart it. We can use the astro mode to get the best quality on the solar eclipse. From 4K video mode, time-lapse mode, bus mode and astro mode, what modes I do recommend are the bus mode and for advanced users the astro mode. So if you want to get the best quality possible, you can use the astro mode, capture the images in FIT instead of JPEGs and process them after. So this I would think, the astro mode I think is the best mode, but it will take a little bit more work. Now let's turn the Dwarf II towards the sun and test more these two modes, the bus mode and astro mode. Also we'll talk about recommended settings to capture the eclipse with the Dwarf II. So let's begin. We'll turn the Dwarf II. So we have more than 60 images. This is just a short test because we don't have yet an eclipse and we'll stop now the burst. So once you'll finish the 1000, just press here on the stop button. And you see it's still tracking, so you can press again and it will restart the plan. If you want to change the settings, you can do this here directly, you see. So let's say we are getting close to the totality phase and we have the diamond ring bellies beats, we can lower it to 150 of a second, you see, and make it brighter, or 140 of a second. This will depend also the atmosphere, so 1-200 is a good place to start the eclipse. If it's hazy and the sky is not so clear, you can go to 160 of a second. Okay, and you can go, let's say, 125 of a second when the totality phase starts, and move after to, let's say, 1/6 of a second to half of a second, 1 second and 2 seconds, or even 3. So you should experiment with these settings. However, I wanted to show you that the bus mode is still working and it will apply the current settings. So if you change the settings, also the new images captured with the bus mode will be taken with the new selected manual settings. So this is the bus mode. It's very easy to use. It will capture all the images on the SD card. You can also change the manual settings while using the bus mode. And this is the most easy method to use with the Dwarf II that will also give the best results. However, the mode that will give you the best quality with the Dwarf II will be the Astro mode. We make sure the sun is in center. We'll select here soundtrack again, yes. And with the Astro mode selected, let's see here the settings. We have here fits that is darker, so this is the one that is actually selected, not TIFF. The highlight should be changed, so maybe put it in red, fits, so people will not get confused. So this is a suggestion for Dwarf Lab. So we have fits. Here we have stacked or single. So it was like this, stacked, but we'll change to single. So we need to see each image for the solar eclipse. And then we'll go binning. We leave it to 4K. So these are the first settings regarding format and resolution. And also we have count. So here we'll push it to maximum 999. And we've done here with these settings. Now we'll go to shutter speed. We'll go with 1/200 of a second, gain zero, and infrared cut. And now we are ready to start imaging the sun with the Astro mode. Let's press start here. And we have a lot of wind. This wind is really blowing now. Okay, so we have stack 13. However, it should show us only the last image, you see, so we don't have any stack image here. It shows us the individual files. Okay, so we finished. So in order to change the settings, we need to stop the Astro mode and end condensation. However, you see the tracking still works. So what we need to do if we want to change the settings now, let's say we are at the totality phase or just before on we want to capture Bailey's beads. We go brighter at 150 or 140. And let's say we want to capture the corona and we go 1 second. Okay, and then we can start another one. So this will be images captured at 1 second. That should make the corona visible. You can experiment, go from 1 second and 2 seconds, but we'll talk a little bit, we'll talk at the end about the settings. Let's say you want to capture the corona, you can change the exposure at 1 second or more. So these are the advantages of using the Astro mode. If you want to get the best quality from the Dwarf II, you could use the Astro mode and get raw quality data when capturing the eclipse. Now, regarding what exposure settings are best to use for the solar eclipse with the Dwarf II, no matter the mode you'll use, the settings should be the same. So to give you more information about this, I will also show you on the PC an exposure calculator for the eclipse. This was made more for DSLR cameras, but we can approximate it and compare here with the Dwarf II. I think a good point to start is 1/200 of a second for the Dwarf II when you image the sun. Once the eclipse will be close to totality phase or in totality phase, you should increase the exposure. Let's say go 150 of a second. This will be good for Bailey's beads and the diamond ring. Now for the corona, I should increase it more. Let's say you start at 125 of a second and see how it will look. You should capture, start capturing the inner corona and then move to 1/6 of a second. For the middle corona, up to half of a second or 1 second to capture the upper corona. So basically, if you want the extended part of the corona, you need longer exposures, like 1 second or 2 seconds to capture it. You have to test it out. Usually 1 and 2 seconds will be okay. If maybe it's hazy, you might need to go even at 3 seconds. I'm now at the computer and I've downloaded the data capture with the Dwarf II Smart Telescope. After processing also the FIS files and the TIFF files, I've noticed the quality seems the same. I didn't observe any
difference in quality. So whatever option you'll select fits or TIFF, you should get the best quality from Astro Mode. What you need to bear in mind that fits or TIFF capture with the Dwarf II at this moment, both will require post-processing in order to get good images of the solar eclipse and to make a video time-lapse. I want to mention that I will attempt also to capture the eclipse live and stream it. So if you will not go and capture the eclipse and you want to see it live, you can check it out on my channel. We'll share the link. And if you'll go and capture the solar eclipse with the Dwarf II, I hope this video helped you to get the best results with the Dwarf II Smart Telescope. Check also the channel membership because I'm sharing there my best astrophotography images, and I hope I'll see you in the next video.